flower of the ocean, pearl of the sea, daughter immortal, come to me, oh, come to me. Oh, come to me.
Come and rise from the water, walk on the sand, goddess of beauty, take my hand, oh, come to me. Oh, come to me.
Oh, come to me.
.313 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Brand new music by Natalie Merchant featuring vocalist Abina Coomson Davis. We just heard Come On Aphrodite, brand new album just released this year. She'll be playing two nights at the Bardavon in Poughkeepsie. And speaking of Bardavon in Poughkeepsie, let's get our friend Mike on the line here. Hold on. Mike, you're with me?
I'm here.
I love that. Always a good start. Awesome. 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 So Mike Nickerson, you're the director of hospitality and programming assistant at the beautiful Bardavon Theater and Ulster Performing Arts Center. You've been there now, what, about 5 years, right?
Five and a half.
Wow.
2017, I started full time.
Time flies when you're having fun. How did you manage to get such an amazing position?
I worked my way in. I started as an event staff out in the parking lots, helping people get the parking spots they needed. And then I worked my way into bartender. And, you know, I think half of life is just showing up and being around when people need you to be there.
Yeah. So. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And I always love seeing you at shows. It's just like so much fun. You live in the Hudson Valley. You're from the Hudson Valley, right?
I was born in Poughkeepsie. I was born at what used to be St. Francis Hospital. And, I've grown up here.
Your whole life. Wow. And did you study theater?
I did. I studied theater and then just kind of worked my way into working backstage. And I fell in love with music and the music industry. And
why and how?
How can you not fall in love with music?
Right, right.
Is the first thing. And then I just had to be involved in it, and I had to figure out how to keep my hands in it continuously.
Do you play anything?
You know, I'm a frustrated musician. I own loads of instruments that I've never learned to play. I have, like, a basic knowledge. I know, like, what chords are and progressions and things like that, but I just can't put it pass my brain into my hands.
But you've put on some great shows for people, so I think that's equally as important, because you've had some good things going on as far as putting shows on yourself. What kind of music were you listening to? The typical radio stuff when you were growing up, or did you always eclectic?
My dad had Beatles albums, so that was always that's a great introduction. And then I had older aunts and uncles who would pass me down Pink Floyd Dark Side of the Moon records, or Rush, or Prince, and then Talking Heads. And part of my formative musical background is WVKR.
Tell me.
WVKR when I was in high school, and then in 1984, that summer, I started DJing between my junior and senior years in high school.
How much fun is that? So we had high school students back then.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, my sister was a big listener to the station and knew, people on the staff, the general manager and stuff like that. And she was younger, but she was like, oh, my brother would be a great DJ.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. What kind of music did you play?
I played a little bit of everything. Mm-hmm. I was definitely into you know, punk rock, a lot of Repo Man soundtrack type of stuff. I remember playing Blues Traveler back when it was the first album was out. Local guys like Agitpop, things like that.
Man, you've got such a great taste in music, so eclectic and so different. I always like to hear how people find some of these groups, right? Because they're not, you know, your everyday music that people listen to. So it's, I love the avant-garde, right. and it's just so cool listening. Well, Mike, you know, there's some open time slots. I'd recommend you to come back if you're ever interested. seriously, I just reach out and let me know because,
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun. I like sharing music. You know, it's really like one of the loves of my life is getting music out there and getting people to come and hear things and see things. Like I said, I've never regretted going to see a live performance.
Absolutely.
Like ever. Like people drag me to shows. I got dragged, believe it or not, to see Stevie Ray Vaughan because I was much more of a punk rocker.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, country blues. You know, I don't know if I want to see Stevie Ray Vaughan at the Civic Center in Poughkeepsie back in 1980 or 86, something like that. And, you know, you can't unsee those things.
Right.
Once you're there, you're like, oh my goodness, this is miracles on stage.
And it's so good to keep an open mind to that musically. I always suggest people, even if you haven't heard of somebody, just go check them out, really, because I love doing that myself, and I'm getting more into doing that as I grow older and just taking a chance because I'm never disappointed when I walk out. It's like, so what? I don't know these people. I'll go and I'll learn about them, you know? And
exactly.
Yeah, no, it's such a cool thing to open yourself up to different forms of music and new music. 100%. I'm with you on that one. Yeah, Mike. Wow. It's so cool talking with you. I was surprised because, of course, Stephen LaMarco was supposed to be our guest today. And now we have you. And I just couldn't think of a better substitute since Stephen is traveling and couldn't make it. So I'm really glad.
I thank the weather for this.
Yes, you thank the weather. And it really worked out super, super well. Now, the live music thing, you know a lot of people, you have put on a lot of shows. Any particular ones in your past that really stand out? Like if you had like a top 10 or a top 5 or some of the shows that you've put on, what stands out?
Well, you just played Natalie Merchant, and she, when she had left 10,000 Maniacs, she was living in Rhinecliff, New York, right there on the Hudson, and I was bartending and booking the Rhinecliff Hotel, an old dive bar venue.
Loved it. Miss it.
Yes, well, I miss it too. And she was just, you know, she and the band would come down after recording and have a beer and relax, and they decided that they wanted to kind of debut their music there.
Man.
So Tiger Lily, before it came out, she came and played a set as an opening act for another local band.
You can't make this stuff up. And she was living down in Rhinecliff at the time. We can say that now because she's not there anymore. So
she's not. No, she's still in the Hudson Valley. Yes. I run into her on occasion in like strange, like Home Goods or. Last time I ran into her was right after New Year's Eve. We were both out for a walk separately on the Shokan Reservoir.
Oh, nice.
Happened to be passing.
Oh.
I was like, I'm really excited for our shows in April.
Yeah.
Said, oh, me too.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Oh, talk about the Rhinecliff Hotel for people that never heard of that or weren't lucky enough to be there. I mean,
sure, that was that I just kind of rode on the shoulders of a giant. Ed Tybus was the owner with his wife, Ruthie, and they had run the Rhinecliff Hotel for years. And somewhere in the 80s, they decided that somebody from Bard College came to them and said, hey, would you mind if we played a show here? And he, you know, looking at beer sales as a possibility, started them up, and that was the first band. One of the first bands I know was a band called Big Noise.
Yeah, I knew them. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know they've gone on. Like one of the drummer went on and was playing with Brian Wilson for a long time, and you know everybody just kind of spun out. They were one of the first bands on MTV. But anyway, so he had started playing, putting on shows there, and I had been working with bands, bringing them in, managing, and just promoting some shows with different artists that I had either met there or had been able to bring in there. And then I started bartending with him, and he had like a Sunday Irish music session with Father Charlie Cohn. He brought in, you know, great, amazing people. Tony Trischka, the amazing banjo player. Yeah. Dream Speak, God Street Wine.
Unbelievable.
You know, bands that were like, yeah, early jam band scene was definitely part of, you know, his real touchstone for him. That was kind of, he was doing some of the same bands that were playing like Wetlands down in New York City at that time.
Right. Man, those were days. I remember hanging out there. The ceiling in the back there, you just were never sure if it was going to cave in or not.
Right, exactly. It was always a question.
Yeah.
Especially when the bass players and everybody's jumping up and down and dancing. And, you know, like local bands like Perfect Thyroid would pack that place.
Yes. Yes.
And it was an amazing time.
And amazing music back then, too. And I miss having something like that, you know. And it was, man, some really great memories. And you also, tell me some of the other artists that you've worked with.
So we had Mo played there, Ominous Sea Pods, a lot of those jam banders, Mercury Rev,
Nora Jones, right? Didn't you work with Nora Jones also?
So then I started working up, when the Rhinecliff closed, I was running a bar up in Tivoli, New York, called the Black Swan.
Yes.
And there we did have Puss in Boots, Nora Jones's cover or country band.
Yeah.
And that was the second time. Both she and Natalie have both said to me separately afterwards, they were just like, Natalie had told me, she, I had never done a show like that before where the audience was just so close. And neither had Nora, where she had felt like, you know, that she was doing a bar band gig.
Right.
And this was after she had been playing, you know, Beacon Theater and like huge venues. So both of them were like, I'll never forget those shows.
Man, yeah. So you're a legend, Mike. You're a legend. I mean, I was in the background there, but I remember you from the Rhinecliff Hotel and certainly remember you from the Black Swan. I grew up in Tivoli, so I was out of there then.
I brought the Avett Brothers there.
Avett Brothers. I mean, come on. Whoa.
The Felice Brothers. A lot of brothers.
A lot of brothers. Wow. Yeah. Well, amazing. Well, I tell you that the Bardavon and UPAC is now lucky to have you and your skills and everything that you bring to the table, because you certainly know how to work with bands. And being the director of hospitality, I mean, that position was made for you.
Yeah, it feels like it.
Yeah.
It feels like it. It feels like everything's been coming to this point. So I'm really excited and happy to be here.
Yeah. No, I'm happy for you as well. And it's a wonderful thing. And I always love seeing you at the beautiful theaters. I mean, Bardavon right in Poughkeepsie, about what, 900-seat theater there?
Yeah, 944 seats.
And then UPAC in Kingston, which is now you're all both the same. What's it, 1,500 or so?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah,
yep.
Yeah.
That's the largest stage between Albany and...
Yep. Oh, did I lose you? I lost Mike Nickerson from the Bardavon and UPAC, but I will guarantee that he's going to call back and we're going to get him back on air just momentarily. We have been speaking with Mike Nickerson, Director of Hospitality and Programming Assistant at the Bardavon in Poughkeepsie, as well as the Ulster Performing Arts Center in Kingston. Both of them are one group. And yeah, I've known Mike for many, many years, but this capacity that he's in now is just fantastic. Until Mike calls back, I think I'm just going to play some music here because we are live on air. I know he's going to call back, you know, live shows. Sometimes things happen, and especially with technology, obviously there's a disconnect. So let us wait for him to call. And there he is. There he is. Hey, Mike, you there?
Yeah, hey, Rita.
Hey. Okay, we're back. We're good.
Okay.
Yeah, no, you know, life happens. It's technology, so whatever. We're here. What were we saying?
Good question. What were we saying?
For this role.
Oh, I was made for this job. Right?
You're made for this job. Bardavon is 940-something seats, and then...
exactly right. And UPAC is 1,500, and that's it's the largest proscenium arch stage between Albany and New York City.
Yes, yes, yes. And both are such beautiful theaters and have been... Right? Oh. It's like going to Broadway. You don't really have to go to the city. You can experience these beautiful theaters right in Kingston and right here in Poughkeepsie. The Bardavon also, you know what I always like to tell people? I'm a strong believer of memberships. If you have a local theater like yourselves, talk to me about your membership.
Well, membership is really... underwrites us and it keeps us going. Our members really do keep us going. And with membership, you get early advance ability to buy tickets. All the shows that we produce, you get $5 off per ticket. So it really can pay itself off in just a short time.
Right.
Especially if you come to a few shows. And that early and being allowed to buy tickets before the general public is kind of, that really... Especially when we have big shows like the Natalie Merchant show, which sold out in an hour, things like that, that sell out very quickly.
Right.
Being able to get in that day before really is the...
is the key. And you're really supporting a very amazing organization that's been around here for 100 and how many years?
Yeah, it's 150, I have to do the math, but...
You know, yeah, like...
Years under 53.
Yeah, I mean, Mark Twain even has history at the Bardavon.
Mark Twain, Houdini had performed here, both Roosevelts as president have come through and spoken here.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's a treasure here in the Hudson Valley. Both UPAC and Bardavon are treasures, and if you know you support venues like this because we need that in order for them to keep going, right? So COVID hit everybody really hard for a couple of years, and you know you guys somehow held your own, which is good. But now it's time to play catch up. So it's really good to become a member at the Bardavon. You can do so online at bardavon.org. Also, if you're there for a show, they'll always ask you for a membership as well. So you can do it right at the box office and your box office. Your people at your staff at the box office is always so welcoming and just so kind, you know. And, you've got some great people there.
Probably the best part about working here is the people I'm working with on a day-to-day basis. That there's not a bad apple in the bunch. We really like to work together, and we hope. Yeah, we like to have people in our theaters. We love to have sold-out shows. We love to see people.
Yep. And so important to keep the music going and to support the local music scene is you know, it's vital. It's vital. And especially after the years that we are just coming off of here and the musicians with their lack of income and being able to perform and theaters like yourselves being shut down and dark, you know. So but with that said, now you have an amazing lineup and let's start talking about this Saturday, March 18th, Newsboys at UPAC.
Right.
Yeah.
That'll be an amazing show. They're a Christian rock band, so it'll be an exciting, full-powered show.
Uh-huh. Yep. Yep. And I love the diversity you guys have too, you know, because you're really, you are all over the place. And I love that. I love that. And then you have the musical, Menopause, the musical at UPAC also this weekend on the 19th.
That's right. On Sunday, we have Menopause, the musical. That that should be an interesting show, and it's selling very well. And I think it will be a lot of fun.
I think so, too. I think so. And talk to me about Jazzed Up. They're at the Bardavon on March 23rd. I've seen you guys have them before. I don't know about them, so I'll need to ask you more.
Sure. Jazzed Up is a great program that we have jazz musicians that go into Poughkeepsie High School and work with students playing jazz, teaching them the form, teaching them a little bit of the history of jazz. And then we have a show on the Bardavon stage with professional jazz musicians and students performing together. And those are always some of my favorite shows when we have students coming in. I performed here at the Bardavon as a 12-year-old in Oliver back in the 80s.
Wow.
So, to see, have kids in here is really, I know that they are the future hospitality directors that may be coming here, or box office salespeople. It will come back to us.
Yes. Yeah. No, it absolutely is. Oh, what a great program. I love the way that Bardavon and UPAC fosters young theater goers and what you offer to school programs. Talk a little bit about that.
We bring 10,000 plus students here every year, sometimes for their first time on coming to a big theater. And we had a show recently that was a retelling of the rabbit, the tortoise and the hare story.
Mm-hmm.
And these little kids are coming in and goes, "Is this a movie? Am I going to watch?" And they came out with huge smiles on their face. There was real people on the stage.
Right.
No, like, touchstone for that before that. But coming out, they were, future theater lovers.
Yeah, yeah. And how exciting to see that as a young person, because normally you sit in front of a screen and it's a movie theater. And the theater, live performances is amazing. Another great performance, March 24th at the Bardavon, Amadeo and Miriam.
I'm so excited for this show.
Wow.
This is one of those ones that I've been pushing for. I love world music, and this band, Amadou and Miriam from Mali, a couple that met at a school for the blind, ran their arts program there and have spun that out to become ambassadors of African music around the world. And the Afrobeat and Afropop sound, and they combine. They're working with electrical music and all these great artists. It's
going to be a very special show. That's at March 24th, and I'm going to tell anyone that's listening, keep it tuned right here, because I've got two pairs of tickets to give away to that show as soon as Mike and I are done talking. So, two lucky listeners, Amadeo and Miriam at the Bardavon, March 24th. And then right after that, I'm also going to have a pair of tickets to give away to your March 30th show at the Bardavon with Postmodern Jukebox.
I love Postmodern Jukebox. I like they take modern songs and do them in these great, doo-wop or torch songs. It's to hear a Metallica song or REM just done as a swing tune. It's really quite amazing.
Yeah. Yeah. I love different interpretations of music that we've heard in a different way. So very cool. And then of course you have the big weekend with Natalie Merchant, April 14 and 15. I think what happened, and you tell me, is that you had one date and tickets sold so quickly that you added on a second show, right?
That's exactly correct. They sold out in about an hour.
Wow.
Which is, it's been a slow drag back after COVID.
Mm-hmm.
We've had a lot of shows that didn't sell well or sold okay, or that we had dragged over from pre-COVID times. that we had a lot of no-shows. But now that things, people are feeling more comfortable coming out.
Right, right.
And shows are selling out.
Yeah.
In a flash. So we originally had the Saturday show booked, and then, it sold out in an hour. So we added the second show on Friday.
Amazing.
And luckily, we were able to do that with her.
And I checked before we came on air. There are literally only handfuls of tickets left. So the one is sold out, but I think there's a few scattered seats.
Probably a couple scattered singles here and there.
Yes.
You know what? I may be speaking at a school and the box office may get mad at me for it. But if there's a show you really want to see, come down and get on the live wait list.
Yep.
Because there's always people turning in tickets that they can't use.
Always. Every night you stand there to get your tickets and at a show, and there's always, this person couldn't come. I have an extra seat. So, that's a great suggestion, Mike. Absolutely.
Any show I really wanted to go to see in my lifetime, I'll go and stand at, shows. When I lived in New York City, I'd go to the Beacon Theater or Irving Plaza, and I always got in.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You gotta, don't just listen to the computer saying sold out. You gotta follow up a little bit with that.
So,
for sure. We have other tickets to give away, which I'm not doing today because I don't have time to give away that many. But they also wanted me to offer Amanda Palmer tickets, which is she's
That'll
coming.
Be a great show.
April 28th. What do you know about her?
What do I know about her? She's one of the two members of the Dresden Dolls.
Mm-hmm.
They had toured back in the day with Marilyn Manson, I believe, and Nine Inch Nails. I don't know how to explain their music. But I love her energy. I've had the chance to meet her in the past. She's married. Do you know who she's married to?
No.
I'm blanking on it. She is married to somebody's yelling, like somebody's listening to the radio right now and yelling at me. I'm like, she's married to Neil Gaiman. See, look at that. It came to me.
See? Wow. I'm impressed. It wouldn't come to me. So, wow.
Who teaches at Bard. So she's another person who has moved to the Hudson Valley. And so we're happy to have Amanda coming, and it'll be a solo night of her performing, playing piano and singing.
Beautiful, beautiful. I love performances like that. Also have the wonderful Cheetah Rivera in conversation with Harvey Fierstein.
Two heavy hitter, like legends. These are really you grow up knowing of these people. You never expect to be getting them water feeding them and getting them meals and being able to have conversations with them.
Right, right. Showing them to their dressing room and, it's amazing. So we'll be giving away a pair of tickets to that as well in the future here next month in April. We'll be doing that as well. And Mike, last time I talked to you, you were so excited about this show I'm about to talk about. May 10th, Woodstock Playhouse, you tell me.
Vote for Aka Touré.
Yes.
His dad's album that he had put out with Ry Cooder, Talking Timbuktu, it was one of those albums from the 90s that I was just always being played around. Like, I was always just playing it.
Mm-hmm.
And his new, Vote for Aka's new album, Ali, that he's put out with members of... No, I'm blanking again. I don't have the album in front of me.
That's okay. It doesn't matter. It's all good.
That's another one. It'll come to. Oh, Karongbin. He put out a great album, Ali. That's his dad's music with the band Karongbin.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't want him to become his family didn't want him to become a musician. They wanted him to follow not his father's footsteps, but his grandfather's footsteps, and they wanted him to become a soldier.
Mm.
But he was just, the music was in him so much that he went out. And I love the stories of the music of the Mali and the Vote for Aka Touré and those guitarists and the sound that they get.
Yes.
There was cab drivers who had copies of Dire Straits' Brothers in Arms. And they had played them and played them, and the cassettes, the tape would get stretched out So the music got this kind of warped sound to it. And they would re-record it and just, like, share the tapes around.
Love it.
And that kind of inspired and affected how their guitar sound has come out. Mm-hmm. I just think that's such a fun way for, like, a musical style to get adapted on.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I like the fact that the Bardavon and UPAC have had a few shows at the Woodstock Playhouse. It's a great collaboration between you guys.
Yeah, that came about through our great friend Jack DeJeanette,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
who has decided that at 80 he is kind of done touring,
mm-hmm.
but still enjoys playing, and so he wants to do local things. He lives in Woodstock, yep. Another great Hudson Valley musician, and so he did a show with Savion Glover,
yes.
at the Woodstock Playhouse.
That was incredible. My girlfriend bought me a ticket for my birthday last year.
Nice.
We saw, wow, that,
yeah.
just like unbelievable. I have no words or adjectives to describe that show. It was unlike anything I've ever seen before.
Yeah, and then we did a great show with Dave Holland, his old bass
yep.
player, musician extraordinaire. And then at UPAC in December, we did a great show with John Batiste.
Yes, yes,
and,
yes.
We are planning some more shows.
Nice.
With Jack, hopefully another one in August.
Oh, great. That's his birthday in August.
Exactly. It will be on his 81st birthday.
Oh.
And he wants to do a reimagining of Bitches Brew.
Oh, come on.
That he played on.
Oh, you got to get Lenny White. He was the drummer on that.
Well,
you can't because Jack's the drummer, but him and Lenny White were on that album.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and what we I think we, you know, there's a few people that have been mentioned. One I cannot say simply because he is touring,
right.
And he has shows, and we're not going to be able to announce the special guest until basically the days before, right,
wow.
the day before.
Wow! Okay. Good. Oh, my gosh. I love shows like that. Just the anticipation. It just makes you
yeah.
want to buy the ticket. You just don't care, right?
Yeah.
Because you know
well,
it's going to be.
That would be a great one to have a membership for.
Yes.
Because those tickets are going to be, like, once the headliner, not that Jack's not the headliner.
Right.
But, and then the undercard, it's like, you know, it's like Mike Tyson boxing under the undercard for Muhammad Ali. But,
right.
Like, the level of musicianship on that show is going to be.
Sick.
Second to none.
Yeah, yeah. No,
and,
I mean,
and it's a one-off. Mm-hmm. It's not a tour you're going to be able to see anywhere else.
Right, right. And that's the beautiful thing, having Jack as our neighbor here in the Hudson Valley. So,
exactly.
You know, you see him about town, too, in a restaurant or something like that.
Uh-huh.
He's, you know, just sitting there with Lydia and, you know, enjoying a nice dinner. And, you know, this jazz
yeah.
legend, NEA jazz master, too. So, yeah,
yeah,
no, amazing. Now, I bought tickets to see Jacob Dylan and the Wallflowers at UPAC. And I bought those tickets for a girlfriend as a birthday gift. I usually buy concert tickets for people as gifts because,
uh-huh.
you know, it's a great thing to do. And I,
yeah.
unfortunately, am going to be away. So I uh-huh. transferred those tickets to her and she will be going with another friend. So, what a show that's going to be at UPAC on May 12th.
That's actually at the Bardavon.
Oh, it's at the Bardavon. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
I wrote that
yeah.
down wrong.
No, that's
right. That's May 12th, Jacob Dylan and the Wallflowers at Bardavon. And I'd be surprised if I'm guessing there's still a few tickets. I don't know. I didn't look that show up, but I know they were selling quickly.
They are selling very well. I'm sure there are still some seats left for that show. But,
right.
Don't sleep on it.
Don't sleep on anything here. And then I'm going to end it up by saying you've got the legendary Buddy Guy, June 15th at UPAC.
His farewell tour. This is it.
Wow.
He's on his way out.
Yeah.
And we were really excited that I love Buddy Guy, but I've been trying to get us to book Samantha Fish,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
who will be opening for him, and it just hasn't worked out. But I'm really, that double bill, it's going to be a night of the blues.
Oh, man, so much fun. So much fun. Such great, great, great music coming to the Bardavon and UPAC. Again, listeners, if you're tuned in, check out the lineup at bardavon.org. Become a member. Get those tickets a little bit early. Save a couple of dollars each time you buy a ticket. And support local. You're supporting an amazing local arts nonprofit organization. I really can't. I've seen some of the best shows at your theaters, you know, always memorable shows for sure. And I know there's probably nothing you can say, and I'm not going to put you on the spot, but Chris usually sometimes has a teaser for us. Are there any other new announcements that are coming out soon?
I could tease it. Let's see. What can I tease you with? Well, we have our gala coming up just 2 days after the Buddy Guy show with Patti LuPone.
Beautiful.
The Broadway diva, a classic of all time. That'll be on the 17th.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else do we have? We have a show with Big Thief that I think is also sold out already in July.
Wow. Yeah.
I mentioned Jack DeJohnette's show in August.
Mm-hmm. Look out for that, everybody. And there's also, you know, I get the press release, but I also get a regular release. You can get on the Bardavon. They have a mailing list. So
yes.
You kind of...
Email list. And a real mail, actual in your hand, get mail from the post office.
Mm-hmm.
Send those out too, postcards mm-hmm. and reminders and announcements.
And that's a great way to find out what's coming on. Also, of course, and not everybody, but most people are on social media. Of course, you want to follow Bardavon and Ulster Performing Arts Center, because every time you guys have an announcement, it is on those networks that you can find it as well.
Yes.
But email is great, because, you know, most of us have too much junk on our social media and you miss stuff. You just do.
I always miss stuff.
Somebody he's like, oh, you didn't see that post? I'm like, no, I didn't see that post. You know, so
there's a show in Kingston tonight that I found out months ago about, but it had been announced much earlier and was already sold out.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not able to go tonight to see that show. So.
Right. So it's so email is great, because usually that's right in front of you. It's on your inbox and all of that. And Mike, it's so cool talking with you. Thank you for doing all the music stuff that you've done here in the Hudson Valley and supporting the local stuff and continuing to do so. I could not be happier for your role at Bardavon and UPAC. It's just the perfect pairing for you. It really is. You're meant to do what you're doing, and you do it oh so well. So thank you. And thank you for your time. I'm going to play some music, give some tickets away, and say thank you to you. And I'll see you at a show, my friend.
Jerry, good. Thank you. I love your show. I listen to it every week. I always hear something that I really enjoy. And it's
thank you so much
fun to have you on the air. And thank you for doing what you do. Getting this word out is as important as what I do.
Absolutely. And really, I'm going to be in touch with you about something, but consider coming back to the airwaves here. So
sure. Anytime.
Yeah. All right. Sounds good. Mike, you have a good night, and I'll see you soon.
My pleasure.
Right.
Thank you so
Take care.
Much. I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. 91.3 WVKR Independent Radio, Poughkeepsie, New York. Mike Nickerson from the Bardavon and UPAC. He's the Director of Hospitality and the Program Assistant. So many great shows you just heard us talk about coming to the area. Either to UPAC, which is the Kingston Theater, or the Bardavon, which is right here in Poughkeepsie. So two amazing theaters. I'm going to give away tickets now. So if you want to go to a couple of shows, I'm going to give away tickets right now to Amado and Miriam. You do have to be able to go to the show. Please don't just call to win tickets. The show is on March 24th. It's at the Bardavon right here in Poughkeepsie. And you and a guest can win a pair of tickets to come see Amado and Miriam. I'm going to play their music right now. And March 24th is a Friday night. It's a week from this Friday, and it's in Poughkeepsie. So if you'd like to come to see Amado and Miriam at the Bardavon, I'm giving away two pairs of tickets to two lucky listeners. The phone number to call here at WVKR is 845-437-7178. The number to call for tickets to Amado and Mariam on March 24th at the Bardavon, 845-437-7178. It's going to be a great night of music. The phones are already ringing. I'll take two callers. So if you're calling, stay on the line because I'm going to get to you. Amado and Mariam, March 24th. Let's take a listen to their music right here, right now on 91.3. WVKR, Amado and Mariam. We just heard the track called Fantani. And we have two very excited and happy ticket winners. Two people won each a pair of tickets to go see Amado and Mariam at the Bardavon March 24th. And lucky winners, Donna and Diane, will have a pair of tickets waiting for them at Will Call to see this amazing, eclectic show at the Bardavon. Thank you again to Mike Nickerson for being my guest here today. And let's keep this ticket going. We're going to give away another pair of tickets right now to see a Postmodern Jukebox. And hold on, I'm just pulling up the video and the track, and we're going to play this, and I can't wait for you guys to hear this track because it's so cool. They're doing the Running Up That Hill, the Kate Bush cover here, Western style cover, and it's a really cool track that I want to share with you guys. So Scott Bradley's Postmodern Jukebox will be playing at Bardavon. I'm giving away one pair of tickets to that show, which is on Thursday, March 30th. Please don't just call to win tickets, but actually be available to go. Thursday, March 30, Scott Bradley's Postmodern Jukebox will be at Bardavon. Tickets are available at bardavon.org, or better yet, be a lucky caller right now here at WVKR, and I'll give you a pair. The phone number again to call here, 845-437-7178. You and a friend will be seeing, courtesy of Bardavon and here, Local Motion on 91.3, you're going to be seeing the Postmodern Jukebox at Bardavon, March 30th. Tickets available at bardavon.org, or just give us a call here and I'll give you a pair, 845-437-7178 for Postmodern Jukebox. Let's take a listen to some music from them right here, right now. And again, the show is Thursday, March 30. The phone number to call, 845-437-7178 to see Postmodern. 845-437-7178.
You wanna hear about the view?
still a pair of tickets available to see these guys. Postmodern Jukebox at the Bardavon on March 30th. Give us a call at 845-437-7178. March 30 at Bardavon, 845-437-7178.
Say if I only could, I'd make a deal with God. I'd get him to swap our places. I'd be running up that road, be running up that hill. It's no problem. Say if I only could, ooh, make a deal with God. Burning up, burning up, burning up that deal. No.
.313 WVKR caller, if you stay on the line, you know what I'll do? Let me start another track here and let me take this call because we're giving away a pair of tickets. Let's take a listen to a track by Wallflowers here on 91.3.
Pointless. Get more vacay than you pay for. Book now. No cruise ships were harder than packing this package.
You were born on your feet. With the stem of a rose between your teeth, or from a cloud of golden air where the sky meets the city streets, you were already wise to a world that's bitter as it's sweet, with both kinds of magic, and God never gets his sleep. Now, darling, hold. I'm far, but I'm not gone. Hold on. I'm always where you are. Hold on. I'm far, but I'm not gone. Hold on.
Some stars, they don't shine as long as others, they just slide and slip away. Sun goes down tomorrow, doesn't call the names. Light as a feather, white as snow, like lanterns off they go, as if whoever brought them here has come to take them home.
And darling,
91.3 WVKR. We had one other happy winner. We gave away three pairs of tickets just within the last hour. Congratulations to Henning. He won tickets to go see Postmodern Jukebox at Bardavon on March 30. So we're nearing the end of the show here. So just a few minutes left. I'm going to run through musical happenings in the hopes that you go out and support live music. We do this in alphabetical order. We always start with the Bardavon. March 24, Amado and Miriam. March 30, Scott Bradley's Postmodern Jukebox. Bearsville Theater, Woodstock, March 30, Woodstock Book Fest. April 15, Rick Wakeman of Yes. City Winery, Hudson Valley in Montgomery. April 2nd, Papa Chubby. Colony in Woodstock, tonight Spaghetti Eastern Music. Thursday, Ghost Funk Orchestra. Friday, St. Patty's at